Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Repair and Replace. If your refrigerator has power, the lights work, but the refrigerator isn't starting, then it could be one of several problems. If the fans are not working, then it's most likely an issue with the cold control, the defrost control, or the control board. This is what we'll be exploring in this episode. However, if you can hear the fans running, or there's a dull hum coming from the compressor, then it's most likely an issue with the compressor or the starting components. You can see how to troubleshoot the compressor in the video linked below. In this episode, first, we'll learn how it all works. Then, we'll test each component with a multimeter. This applies to most top freezer, bottom freezer, and side-by-side refrigerators. All refrigerators work in the same basic way. When cooling is needed, the cold control sends power to the cooling circuit. The compressor pushes the refrigerant through the system. In the freezer, heat is extracted by the evaporator coils and is released through the condenser coils behind the refrigerator. This process continues until the set temperature is reached. A faulty cold control thermostat will not send power to the compressor and fans. It could also be an issue with the defrost circuit. Models that use a cold control thermostat will have a defrost timer or a defrost control board. The defrost heater periodically turns on to melt the ice on the evaporator coils. When the cycle begins, the defrost control shuts off power to the cooling circuit. If the defrost control is faulty, then it can prevent the compressor and fans from running. Some models use a control board instead of a cold control thermostat. In this case, a faulty temperature sensor or control board can also prevent the system from working properly. Using a multimeter, components can be tested for continuity. A continuity test will determine if there's a continuous path for electricity to flow through. Without continuity, the component will not work and will need to be replaced. To begin, you might need a screwdriver or nut driver and a multimeter. Keep in mind there is some variation between models, and not all refrigerators will have the same parts. You can enter your model number on the AMRE Supply website to see a parts breakdown. This can be helpful to show you which parts are in your refrigerator and where they are located. First, slide the refrigerator out from the wall. When there is enough room, unplug the cord to disconnect the power. In this case, you can work on the refrigerator in place with it still against the wall. Some models use a cold control thermostat, which will be near the top of the fridge compartment. These have a physical dial instead of buttons. Remove the screws and lower the control housing. It might be held in by plastic tabs, so don't force it or it might break. In some cases, you can disconnect the wires and remove the entire housing. Depending on the model, you might have to remove the dial first. Now lift up and disconnect the wires. Next, remove the thermostat and the sensing bulb. Set the multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. With the dial turned to any cold setting, test between both terminals. you should get a continuity reading between 0 and 1 ohm at room temperature. If it fails the test, then the thermostat is faulty and will need to be replaced. Take the new thermostat and align it into the housing. Now push the sensing bulb into the mount. Next, reconnect the wires. Now push the dial back into place. The defrost timer switches power between the cooling and defrost circuits. On top of the timer is a motor that spins the cam. One full cycle takes about 8 hours of runtime to complete. There are four numbered terminals. Terminal 1 is the common terminal. Terminal 3 is for the timer motor. Terminal 4 is for the cooling circuit, which is powered any time the cold control is active. Terminal 2 is for the defrost circuit. Once the timer starts the defrost cycle, it will run for about 30 minutes, or until the frost is melted. Then power switches back to the cooling circuit. First, remove the defrost timer. This might be held in by tabs or by a mounting screw. Now remove the wire connector. Set your multimeter to the continuity or resistance setting. To test the cooling mode, check terminals 1 and 4. The cooling circuit will be energized for the majority of the time, so you should get a continuity reading. Turn the advancement screw until it clicks. This should disconnect the circuit, so there will be no continuity. Now, if the defrost timer fails any of these tests, then it's faulty and should be replaced. Keep in mind, testing terminals 1 and 3 might not show you a normal reading as the motor uses a small capacitor. This means in most cases you can't check the motor. If you think that the motor has failed, then replace the defrost timer. Align the control housing and reconnect the wire harness. Now tighten the mounting screws. Some models use a sensor and a control board to regulate cooling. The temperature sensor is a heat-sensitive resistor, also known as a thermistor. As the temperature changes, so does the resistance. The control board monitors the resistance to determine the temperature. To test the sensor, it can be helpful to use a resistance chart, which is sometimes printed on the tech sheet. The tech sheet is normally behind the kick plate. It also might be mounted at the back, or will be hidden under one of the top hinge covers. In many cases, the sensor can be accessed by removing a small cover. Disconnect the sensor wires and remove it. Now set the multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. Next, touch the probes to each terminal. At room temperature, we're getting a resistance of 2600 ohms, which is close to the rated value. For accuracy, it's best to take another measurement to compare. Test in a glass of ice water with a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. As the thermistor cools over several minutes, the resistance should now be close to the second value. If either test differs more than 10% from the rated value, or if there is no resistance and no continuity, then the sensor is faulty and should be replaced. Push the sensor into the bracket and reconnect the wires. Align the cover. Now tighten the mounting screw. If you have eliminated all other problems and the refrigerator is still not working properly, then it could be a problem with the control board. The board is often located near the back or in a small box behind the kick plate. First, do a visual inspection of the board. If you see any charred or blackened spots, then it's a good sign that there's a failed component or a short circuit in the board. As well, double-check that all the wire connectors are secure. A loose connection might prevent components from receiving power. In many cases, it's best to install a new control board. You can see more in the video linked below. Plug in the cord to reconnect the power. Now slide it back into place. Make sure to leave a couple of inches of space between the refrigerator and the wall. This will allow for proper airflow. Now test the refrigerator to see if it's working properly. If you like this and want to see more tutorials and informational videos, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.